How I fixed a failed Windows 10 update. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Ask Leo is sponsored in part by the support of many, many supportive patrons. Thank you. If you'd like to become a patron and get perks like an ad-free experience when visiting askleo.com, or depending on your level, access to exclusive content, visit askleo.com/patron to find out more. So, like many techies, we get asked questions all the time by our friends, our families, and our neighbors. A couple of weeks ago, a neighbor came up to me, or gave me a call actually, and said, "Hey, my machine took a Windows 10 update, and now it's stuck. It's in the boot phase and it's been there for hours. What do I do?" So, longer story short, I went down and visited him and worked on his machine to get it working again. I was successful. Rather than focusing on exactly what was wrong with his machine, to be honest, we still don't know, I'm going to show you some of the steps that I took to get there, some of the tools you have available to you if you find yourself in a similar situation. So here's my Windows 10 home machine. As you can see, it's working. Let's assume for a moment that it's not. I'm going to start by rebooting it. And what's important about this reboot is that at a certain point, as soon as it starts the boot process, in other words, it's gone from the black screen, your BIOS screen, or whatever, to actually loading Windows itself, I'm going to turn it off. Now, in the virtual machine, that's a menu option I have. In your case, you might long press the power button to make that happen. You can see it's rebooting again, and I'm going to do it again. I'm going to turn it off again. This time, when it comes back and when it starts to reboot, you'll see that it is now in something called automatic repair. This is the magic, if you will, that gives you access to a number of repair tools, including safe mode. Now, it's starting by diagnosing my PC. All it knows at this point is that something interrupted the boot process a couple of times. Doesn't really even know that it's me. It's just, hey, we didn't boot twice in succession. Let's run some diagnostics. At this point, it says, well, we didn't really find anything, but if you want to just restart, we can try one more time, or we can try again. That's not what we want, of course. What we want are some of these advanced options, so that's what I'm going to click on. Now, once again, we've got a couple of easy outs here. One is, if we assumed everything was working, we could just continue and it would continue to boot into Windows 10. Or, at the other end of the spectrum, if you were done or you wanted to give up or whatever, you could simply turn off the PC at this point. Naturally, what we want is in the middle, troubleshoot. Now, this option, reset this PC, is essentially a reinstall of Windows. In my friend's case, that's not necessary. It was on the table, don't get me wrong. It's something that I knew in the back of my mind we might need to use. We didn't, and this is where it would be. Once again, you've got the option of resetting your PC with and without saving your data. Hopefully you already have things backed up, so the difference may not really matter to you. But if you wanted to reinstall Windows, this is the option you would use. That obviously would be the moral equivalent of reinstalling it from scratch and would solve a lot of different problems in its configuration and other issues. Instead, we're looking for advanced options. Now, in advanced options, we have several different things we can play with. Startup repair does exactly what it says. It actually looks for things that commonly prevent startup from working. The problem I was facing with the Windows update failure didn't feel like a startup problem, so it's not what I used. But if, for whatever reason, you encounter a problem starting up your machine, this is one way to let Windows attempt to automatically repair many of the things that are common causes of startup failures. Startup settings we'll take a quick look at, because there are a number of things that you can do. This is the gateway to safe mode, by the way. You'll see that it's on the list about halfway down. There are a number of things you can change. The catch at this point is that you have to reboot once again to enter this particular mode. I'm not going to do it. Again, it's another option I had on the table when I was diagnosing my friend's machine. It turns out that it wasn't necessary, but it is something that is useful to know about. Very often you'll see that you get instructed to restart in safe mode in order to diagnose particular driver problems, video problems, whatnot. This is how you would get there. I'm going to go back. There is, of course, the command prompt, the Windows command prompt. This is not something I ended up needing, but once again, it's a valuable tool, especially if you're aware of command line tools that you want to run specifically for the problem you have at hand, or if you've been instructed to run certain command line tools to attempt to solve a problem. System image recovery. This is the option to restore a backup image you had taken previously. The catch is that this is Windows system image. So this only works if you had been using Windows image backup. My friend had not. He's been running ESA's to do. On the table for ways to recover this machine would have been to boot from the ESA's recovery media and restore an image from his ESA's backups. We elected not to do this. We ended up not needing to do this. If you've been using Windows backup, then this is how you would restore a Windows backup image. System restore. I tried system restore. I don't like system restore. System restore failed. It took its time failing. By that I mean it offered me a couple of different restore points to restore to. I chose one that I thought was appropriate immediately prior to the Windows update having occurred, and I turned it loose, and it churned. And it churned for quite a while. And after all of that churning, it said, sorry, system restore could not restore your system. It failed. That was both frustrating, because I was kind of hoping that this was the kind of a scenario that a system restore would recover from, but also somewhat validating, because I have said many, many times that I dislike system restore. This is exactly one of the reasons that I dislike it so much. It has the promise of a solution. It says there's a restore point, and yet it fails to actually restore. What that left us with was uninstall updates. Uninstall updates, while seeming a bit extreme when a Windows update happens, it seemed a logical thing to try at this point. The issue was that the machine was working, it took Windows update, and then it wasn't working. So if we can roll back or uninstall the most recent update, that might get us a working machine. Now, if you choose it, you have two options. There are the uninstall the latest quality update. These are the more frequent Patch Tuesday kind of updates that have to do with security problems and minor bug fixes, other small features and enhancements. And then the other, of course, is the latest feature update, which is the update that happens every 6 months or so that actually comes with a fair amount of feature changes and other changes to the operating system. This particular update that had just been taken was a quality update. So this is what I did. I allowed Windows to uninstall the latest quality update. And you know what? That worked. After running through the uninstall process for the various updates that had been installed, the system rebooted and it rebooted back into Windows. Now, since I don't have to do that on my test machine here, I'm going to let the machine exit and continue to Windows 10. Because there's one more thing that I think is important to consider if you find yourself in this situation. So let's review what we've done so far. In my friend's case, his machine had failed after a Windows update. I was able to uninstall that latest update, and that got him a working machine. In a traditional world, Windows update is still running. It's very likely that whenever it decides to, it's going to install that update again. It may or may not work. If it does it the very same day or later that evening, then it's almost certain not to work and get us back to where we were to begin with. So, what I wanted to do instead was delay further updates on his machine. The way I did that, and even in Windows Home this works, you can go to Updates and Security and select Pause Updates for 7 days. In fact, you can say multiple 7 days. And at this point, I've got it set for paused for 7 days. 7 days from now is 7.3. If I now say 7 more days, it goes up 7.10. That's 2 weeks. Windows Update will not take an update for 2 weeks. This is also exactly what I did with my friend's machine. I said, let's just take a breather. Let's not take any Windows updates for the next 2 weeks. As it turns out, that was probably a good thing to do. The theory by pausing updates in the situation like this, after just having had a Windows update caused failure, is that you're probably not alone. There are probably other people that have suffered the same problem. Not many, certainly wasn't headline making stuff, but it happens. The idea is that maybe Microsoft will notice and will fix this update with another update. With something we've heard of from time to time, you'll see news of a Windows update coming out, and then a couple of days or a week later, there'll be, oh, by the way, here's another piece to the update that fixes something that the update broke. 2 weeks is a nice window to let things settle. And after 2 weeks, the machine would take updates again. If they failed, well, we know we had a more significant problem and we would need to decide what to do next. Probably I would delay updates even further, or I'd consider reinstalling Windows. On the other hand, there's a likely chance that the updates would work. And in fact, after leaving my friend's home, after working on things for a couple of days, sure enough, I saw a headline in one of the tech newspapers that said essentially, yep, there was a bug in the update. It affected so-and-so kind of machines. There's a fix for it. It's getting rolled out right now. So there's actually a very good chance that the next time this machine takes an update, it's going to work. So that is the process that I took on my friend's machine. And like I said, hopefully I've exposed you to a few of the options that you have available to you simply by entering this diagnostic mode by, again, interrupting the boot process 2 times in a row. There are other solutions that we could have used. I could have restored a backup image. We could have poked around in safe mode for a bit and seen if there was anything we could have done there. The command line, I could have done some more research into the specific kind of failure associated with this Windows update, and perhaps there would have been command line tools to use. And finally, and what I still have on the back burner in case that next update continues to fail, is I could reset the PC, which boils down to installing Windows from scratch. So I do need to close with one little confession. I didn't really fix anything. The title of this article is How I Fixed a Windows 10 Update. I didn't fix anything. All I did was work around the problem. The problem is still there. Until the update itself is fixed by Microsoft, the problem is still there. There was nothing I could fix, to my knowledge. I simply worked around the problem and delayed the update so that hopefully Microsoft would have time to actually do the fix. From my friend's perspective, of course, it was fixed because he had a working machine. But from my perspective, from a pedantic perspective, I didn't fix anything. All I did was sidestep the problem. And I also want to point out that by and large, Windows Update usually works. It updates millions of machines every day, and by and large, they all work. Of course, there are always going to be edge cases, like my friends. That's why we back up. That's why we learn about the tools we have available to us to try and fix things when things do go wrong. Hope that was helpful. I hope that gives you some insight into some of the things you can do when things go wrong. For related links, for updates, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/134428. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.